Thanks, guys. Hey, thank you. All right. All right, good afternoon. Let's see if we can get something going. Yeah, all right. Oh, that's me. All right, so, well, where can we start? Let's start with this. I can remember when I was a little kid in school, and I had music, right? I had band multiple times a week. And it was incredible. That's where I learned to play an instrument. And the funny thing about that is that that was the beginning. Being back in this room, if I remember correctly, this is where we actually used to do choir when I sang in LMU's choir many years later. So that was a start for me. I had music. I had PE multiple times a week. I had theater. I had art. It was all there for me. And then I used to teach in private schools, and boy, they had everything. I taught PE, and the kids in my school, we had PE. Gosh, every student had PE every single day with me. They had art, they had theater, they had music, they had it all. Well, I run this place called Heart of LA, as you heard. It's 5 minutes west of downtown LA, okay? It's in a really densely populated area. There's high poverty and lots of kids of color, low socioeconomic. And it was about a year ago that I met a teacher there. He was teaching science at one of the high schools in the area. And it was awesome. He came to me and he said, you know, I'm a science teacher at this school. Things are going really well. I was a little bit concerned because a lot of my students were having challenges really staying engaged in academics. So I thought, how can I appeal to this group of kids? And then he remembered, this is the Glee generation I'm talking about. So he decided to start a Glee club. Okay, this Glee club was incredible. These kids worked really, really hard. They actually started to do well in school. Better in school than they were doing before. He actually found some outside money to fund this Glee Club at the high school, and these kids had the opportunity to play with the rock legends Foreigner on NBC Latino for their parents and family to see. And I'm thinking, this is great. Good for you. But then this happened. Less than a month ago. Hi, Tony. Hope this finds you well. I've been really busy these last couple of days. It turns out that I will not be returning to teach at the high school next year. I saw this coming the way things have been moving. I was one of the last survivors at the school. We've seen half of our staff cut in the past 6 years. But now, I'm the science teacher with the lowest seniority. I've received notification yesterday that I'm being displaced due to low enrollment, 37 kids. I'm looking into many options and deciding whether I should seek employment at a district high school or stay within the public school system. My priority is to continue growing the high school choir, so I need to stay local in some capacity. And even if I don't find a position in a high school in the neighborhood, I hope to still partner somehow with a school or two. My vision is to have a space in a central location that is independent of the schools, but also allows me to work closely with them. It's difficult for me to understand the lack of support, but it's the same old story about the focus on the core curriculum, which relegates the arts to mere elective course status. I was also notified yesterday by the principal that if my displaced status changes next year, my choir class will be closed. 2 years ago, our band program was cut, with declining enrollment and smaller school budgets. There's an increasing unwillingness to support any music programs. So let's talk. So my question to you guys is this. How are we feeling about our educational village? You know, I know what I think. I think our village is too small. I think we need to put back into schools what's being cut, stripped out, watered down. We got to get back to what keeps kids engaged if we want to see more kids of color succeed. There's actually quite a bit of research that's looking into this area as well. You see a Harvard research project. They looked at all these cities besides LA. And I think we need to get into LA. There's some great stories here that we'll talk about. But they're noticing that there's some qualities to after-school, out-of-school programs that can absolutely help to lead to higher achievement for kids in school. So in other words, we can work together to make our village even stronger. We just have to create a bigger village around education. So when the YMCA of Long Beach created this Youth Institute for high school students, They were giving them a high quality of academic support and instruction. It was very intense. And they were giving them activities and programs that the kids were really interested in. And what did they see? They saw these results. They saw that the kids coming into the Youth Institute had very high GPAs relative to the opposite, the rest of the school district in Long Beach there. They were performing better in school, or had higher GPAs. They had lower truancy issues, lower attendance problems, right? And they were performing really well on their standardized test compared with the rest of the district. So there was something to be said for high quality out of school programs, right? And centers. And you look at the headlines, you know, back at the start of this talk, and what did we see? We saw headline after headline talking about schools this, schools that, schools this, schools that. And that educational village, which just gets obliterated. I mean, those stories were like a week old, a few days ago, weeks before that. So here we are. What does the ideal collaborator look like? I want to share something with you. When I was at Heart of LA, my first few years, I was meeting a lot of 16 and 17-year-olds who'd been coming. They were off the streets, away from gangs. We were sort of the typical after-school program at the time. And what I would tell you is that these kids felt great about coming. But I would understand weeks later that these 16 and 17-year-olds couldn't read and write beyond a third grade level. And their math was about the same place too. And so I said, there's more that we can do here. So I went into the founder's office and I said, I want to make sure that our kids, starting at elementary, have the fundamentals in language, arts, and math. I want to make sure that the parents have some place to go, because they know that Heart of LA is the center of trust. They know that their out-of-school centers can be that, right? So we said, listen, what do you parents need from us? How can we help you with the academic process? You know what they said? They said, would you go to our parent-teacher conferences with us? That would really help us a lot, so that we're learning together how best to support my children. Because in many cases, our parents felt like they didn't have the same educational attainment that their kids had already had. So we said we'd do that. We also said that we'd provide intense activities and opportunities for these kids after school to support their academic achievement, but also giving them the things that they really needed and wanted in life. And that's where I want to tell you a quick story. I had a friend named Ricardo. Ricardo started with us, and he was not a very expressive person. You know, he wouldn't look you in the eye. His head was always down. He was having problems in school. Right, he was about to fail, as a matter of fact. The teachers more than once came to us and said, you know, we've really got to figure out where we're going to move this kid to. And yeah, he had expression issues at school in that village, in that small educational village. But let me tell you what he was doing. He was expressing himself all right. He was expressing himself all over this picture, all over the Rampart District. On walls, park benches, those green dots are schools. Those are all the schools surrounding buildings 1, 2, 3, and 4. Oh yeah, he hit those up too. He hit up the park. He was tagging everywhere. In fact, he even tagged a postal truck. And when he did that, he didn't understand that that was any different than, say, one of those green dots. So we intervened, kept him from being another statistic of a low socioeconomic kid of color on his way, pathway to prison. Right? And we said, no, let us give him more art, let us give him more academic support, we can help this young man. So we gave him art, and we challenged him and challenged him. We said, start painting on canvas instead. Get it out, my friend. And let me tell you what he did. He graduated high school on time. Not only did he graduate high school on time, he started selling his artwork. His artwork is now collected by people from all around the world. In fact, he just sold out a show at Bergamot Station. He's been asked to come to colleges and universities across the country and speak and present, which he's done. And his artwork is now all over the world. Best of all, he's come back to this larger educational village, and he's preventing the next group of kids out of building number two, he's preventing the next group of kids from spray painting and expressing all over town and helping them to put it onto a canvas and become this very same success story that he is now. See, that green circle wasn't big enough for him. He didn't have arts in his school. He didn't have it in middle school. He didn't have it in high school. It was very watered down, but now he's got it. And when we gave it to him in buildings 1, 2, 3, and 4, lots of cool things started to happen. What do buildings 1, 2, 3, and 4 do? They partner, they collaborate. You know, I think if we can start to think about a bigger educational village, we can see really cool collaborations come to fruition. We can see all of these green circles feeding into buildings 1, 2, 3, and 4 to access counseling that's been dropped, high quality arts programming that's been dropped, language arts, math, science, humanities. We can partner with organizations like the LA Phil to give these really rich and deep and profound music experiences. We partner with the LA Phil in this community. We're serving kids in all of these green dots. Okay, we have 240 kids who come for 15 hours a week. Okay, 15 hours a week. They can't get that anywhere else. But the village is big for them now. And you want to know what that means? That means that these very same students are doing what they're doing now. They're playing in Walt Disney Concert Hall. They're playing at the Hollywood Bowl. They're one of the young men who's in that program was a gangster, enrolled in the program. Next thing you know, last year he's on a plane with me to London to play with Gustavo Dudamel and an honor orchestra in Europe. So these things can work. The results, well, I think the stories are the results, but it gets better. In that neighborhood I showed you, where less than 65% of the kids are graduating high schools on time, the good news is this. Kids who are coming to the center, to expanded learning centers like we've talked about, in this widened educational village where arts and music and all these things were put back into the schools when they were stripped out, 100% of them are graduating on time. Not only are 100% of them graduating on time when they go to college, over the last 5 years, we're seeing 81% of the students coming through these centers progress and persist through college. And over the last 2 years, 91%. And we have over 250 kids from this very community in colleges around the country. So, if we can widen the educational village, if we can put back what's been stripped out of our schools, then I think this is what we can see around our city when we think about education. We can see this happening between 4 o'clock and 8 o'clock at night. We can start to see kids get excited about being educated again. We can start to see every kid get a chance to be successful in life. No more do we have to read a headline that says we're wasting $100 million, is it a waste or not? Look, widen the educational village, invest in the village, and these are the kind of results you'll get. This email told us that his choir was being canceled. Well, let's give these kids a home, let's give them a chance, huh? Let's widen the educational village, let's put back what's been stripped out of schools. We don't have to wait for Superman, we can do it right now. Thanks, you guys.
Thank you. Thank you so much.